director, a producer, and also a digital head for a media company. He is currently the digital head of Star Cinema. Okay, so I will let him go siya. Take five. So I will let him go.
Okay, well, good morning. Sabado ngayon. So, do you like the title? Don't tell me hindi mo kilala si John.
Well, John, there's nothing to do with what you have right now. But since that's the only thing I know, I started class right now. When Angie invited me to do IA, I didn't even know what it is. But then, through many emails and messages, na-i-explain niya kahit papano in a lot of links. Yung pala, we're doing it in Star Cinema and in ABS-CBN, in somewhat of a formal manner. And what we do learn in we do have the job. There's the technology, there's the business, and there's the people. What we do know is that the people comes first for us. So actually, thank you for doing half the job. We usually do it like the tripod. You remember the three circles of Edmund Kalina? The technology, the business, and the people. We do it like the tripod when we explain it to our new hires. The tripod will not stand without the business, without the technology, but the biggest leg would be the people. So what we'll be talking about today is not really so techy. So I have a million caveats because I am not a techie, so Piolo will be introducing into the caveats. Hindi ako digital native, as you can say, too old for that, not a tech at all, mas poser ako. I do have the site and the SNS, but if you look at it and you say, ito bang ginagawa niya, bakit ang ano, chararat, whatever, it's so ugly. Hey, it's a work in progress and I'll explain later that just because it's not advanced or it's too masa, doesn't mean no thought came into it. And it doesn't always have to be the top of the line, top grade technological breakthrough that you put into something. It's the heart or the concern for the people who are using it that will give you the best results. We're all fellow creators, journeymen, tinkerers. We're not yet perfect what we do. And at best, really, I feel like a stranger. This is an outsider's point of view to the kind of science art that you do. The best I could say is that I'm a storyteller, so I'm going to tell this in terms of the way stories are made. So, an alternative perspective is the best that I can give, and I hope that's good enough for the morning. So, first question, why are you here? What is the reason that you sacrificed your Saturday for this small room with paintings with no heads? So, why are you here? Yeah.
That
you adapted to my premise, okay. agile, okay. Because what do you do?
I am a product developer.
Oh, of what?
It's an app, actually. It's not out yet, so that they're researching. Yeah, secret. And I thought that IA would open up something.
Maybe this will help. When we talk of our digital products, I'm not so concerned whether you're doing systems, ecosystem solutions, campaigns, apps, websites, microsites, whatever. But that whatever digital is out there, we more or less obey this journey. So just take it for what it is. Maybe let's take another one. The winner. Okay, yes. So, how about you, Jamie?
The reason why I'm here is I'm very interested in the concept and the constructs, but it's not my line, so I'm an open thing, listening to what everybody has.
Oh, concepts and constructs. Yes, but the construct and the concept that you'll be undergoing is more or less a journey or relationship, is what I was hoping to achieve. So, baka mabusan tayo ng oras, so let's go. More or less, some of you have products, systems, solutions, campaigns, maybe you want to do better things, maybe you want better functionality, to be more strategic perhaps with what you're doing, maybe convenience efficiency of their users, like the app that you'll be using, and of course, the third leg, the profit, or the business side of it. But let me suggest another objective. maybe a higher objective, not in the sense that it's more social or more elite, but something that's more encompassing than what we usually do. Because we, for one, and I hope you're not, too, contented with all of those above words that we just said. Because I would suggest that everyone wants love. And you may see yourself in any of those different people. But since you might not have gotten the message, so we'll say love again. And maybe you haven't gotten the message, we'll say love. So we're going to have 20 minutes of love. Yeah, so diba hindi na sayang asapa niya. May konting kel. So love may be with friends, and you love your friends, family, your lovers. I couldn't say boyfriend, girlfriend, or whatever permutation kasi, so Manny Pacquiao and all that. So your community, maybe society, the world, the planet, like Superman. And certainly you want people to love your product, you love your product, you want to spread it. To me, they're higher than profit, more than affinity, let's go straight to love, and is you do not want a single visit, you want loyal users, of course. You want more profits and defenders of what you do, not just people who say, that's okay. And you don't want just income or efficiency, you want love for your brand and love for your product. And so that's what I'll try to do. For a moment, let's not think yet in terms of information, system solutions, logic, design, taxonomy of whatever information you have, or search optimization. Let's just think of love. Because that's how the people will approach whatever you do. No matter how well or how bad you do it, their premise is, will I love you? Let's talk about what we do in my company. Have you heard of Ivana Chabakuru? Who has heard of the name? Wala, no, obviously wala. Siya po ang teacher ng mga artista sa Hollywood na talo na yung mga ibang mga techniques in acting. Siya nagturo dyan. Mga first name basis kami na. So, sabi sa akin, James, kahapon. Ivana did a workshop in ABS-CBN locally, one day lang, 2 days lang, where she did Yolo and everybody else. And for a quick lecture, she had only one ultimate tip. In whatever you do, in whatever you say, maski ang linya mo eh, walang hiya ka, mamatay ka na, gago ka, whatever, no backwards. Gago, pag PG-13, ang gago. So, it's not just PI, so hindi pa R. So, whatever you say, no matter how mad you are, no matter how evil your lines are in the script, you always say it with a subtext. Who knows subtext? What's the word subtext? The one is in your head, underneath the line that you say. So the actor always has a subtext to the real text, the real meaning of the line. So the subtext in every line that an actor says is, anong dapat kong gawin para mahalin mo ako? What do I have to do for you to love? Even if he's cursing, even if she's about to slap 79 girls or 79 mistresses, it's always that line. What do I have to do for you to love? So you know, subtext. Everything in every line, every movie, from the first line to the last line, has a single subtext. What will I have to do to make you love? And I believe that that's also useful, not only useful, maybe critical, maybe the ultimate question you also have to ask in whatever you do digitally. Let's take another example, one that's more recent. We participated in the campaign of Mar Rojas in 2009. Before he stepped down. And he was asking us, parang ako stuck sa 16, 18, hindi ako nagka-20s. Tapos, di ba, parang umulit, he's still stuck in the 16, 18, so hindi siya nagka-20s. There's a thief up there, and he's still down in the 16, 18. Then we said, because Mar, you're a stranger. You're a stranger to the people. How does it happen? How do I make myself an unstranger to the people? I talk naman about what I do. It's not what you do, eh. It's who you are. It's who you are as a sum total of your past and present. And therefore, based on that, they will rely on that to get to know who you are, get to love you, and see what you can do for them in the future. In short, you don't have a relationship. In fact, you don't have a love relationship with the people. paano ba ma-in-love kasi? Sabi ni Mar, sabi ko, well, paano mo pa-in-love si Corina? Baka wala. But, paano ba ma-in-love? Diba? It's a first part of experience. And don't tell me you don't know this. So we'll just review what you did yesterday. Friday. So it's a first part of experience. A first impression. Maybe love at first sight. Maybe not. At least positive impression. Tulad itong dalawa sa elevator. Then, if you get your first impression, are you repelled? Or maybe are you attracted? Then you approach. Maybe he approaches, maybe she approaches, maybe there's the pickup line. Alam mo na, kung ano man yun. Sa isip ko, whatever it is that you hear from John Lloyd. And then the first lock in. Maybe you ask for a date, numbers, ano, website. Ano pa nalang sa Tinder? Ano pa nalang sinasabi? First thing, getting to know you, reveal your humilities. I just use it grammatically. I'm sure you know what I'm trying to say. Make yourself vulnerable. Because you appeal for sympathy. You're paampon like Grace Cole. And organically, you get closer to each other. There's a growing closeness. So there's mutual interest. Tulad ni JM at Angelica. But after that, it doesn't have to be in this order. To some of you guys, baka nauna yung kiss before you meet the person in the dark, yung kiss agad. That's all right. I mean, iba-iba ng order. This is just the general scheme of things. Maaring yung first kiss, maaring first date, and then after a few kisses, dates, gifts, roses, chocolates, sunduan, maybe a few trips together, you decide to commit to something. Oh, sorry. Maybe next second date pa. Then you ask yourself, especially the ladies, I hope you ask yourself, do I like who I'm dating? Alam natin yung dating, hindi gusto. Does he or she make me feel good about myself? Diba? You ask that. Pang matagalan ba ito? Panandalian lang. And I will adjust my strategy or my expectations accordingly. Will I go to bed with him or her? Or with just myself? I hope not. So when you go to bed and you commit, then relationship na. Then, but after commitment, that's where the tests start. I'm sure you know this. May pagsasamahan na kayo, may pinag-iyakan, may tawanan, may pinaglalaban, magulang mo, kaibigan niya, kaibigan mo, logistics, love distance relationships, whatever, problems that star saying might impose on you in their movies. So, that happens in your real life anyway. After all of that, after all the tests of being together, you end up with syempre having a bond. Sana umabot dito. Pag naman nagkabang ka, di pero na talaga forever. Di pa nila inaabi. But Mark is not willing. He's just willing to say what he can do, his promises for the country, all that technical and technological and economic promises, and the Filipinos did not respond. Because at the end of the day, sabi nga, they might even vote a thief, they might even vote a dictator, or maybe a gun-running warlord. But the operative term in any decision-making of most Filipinos is love. Kanino sila? Nagkagusto. More than the logic of it. I'm not saying you don't make your apps logical. I'm just saying that beyond wholesome discipline of logic and technical prowess, there still needs the critical element of loving what you do and love having a relationship with what you think. That's why he stepped down in 2009, and now in 2016, he's still at the 16th. I hope he gets to show that he can be loved. And I hope you don't tell him that I use him for example. Because are related to it. So what you actually heard, that's no big plot, I mean, we're happy to discuss the manuscript writing. What you actually heard is a minimum, bare bones, skeletal love story. But we're all innate storytellers. I don't know if you realize that, but even if you do a simple program or a simple campaign, you're actually telling a story from the time of the cave. We usually start our lectures in ABS-CBN with the cavemen. Even from the time of the cavemen, there is storytelling to express love over the bonfire. That's another lecture and another time. It takes another 30 minutes. But trust me when I say every human being is an innate storyteller. The most simplest uneducated slum-dwelling woman with no education, no need, no right, whatsoever will still tell a story when they're a child. So, bare bones,
no knowledge, may kwento yung tao sa alam niya. All stories are actually love stories. Be it the most experimental French film or the weirdest Unshan Andalou by Bunuel, whatever it is you've probably seen in your collective, they're all stories are actually love stories. All stories show us, humans, who a human being loves and how a human being loves. Who we love and how we love. Those are the two things that we always show in anything that we do. Even in the way we dress up, even in the way we choose our sunglasses, even in the way we make our app systems or solutions. Reflect and check yourself. It's always, when you go out to the world, for every second of breathing, you ask yourself, how can I make people love me? Everybody walks with an invisible placard, love me. Same with your program, same with your app. How can we make them love us? Even online, yeah, our love stories. Everything from every bottle to all the eggs. ONX. It's a love story. It's an indication of how ONX loves us and who ONX loves. Are we still together or have you gone somewhere else? Okay, naman, any questions so far? Filipinos pa, more than other people, look into one particular aspect of the human psyche. If you go to the Americans or maybe to the Europeans, maybe nice, baby design and intelligent algorithm. Yeah, but tayo kasi we go for the heart, the soul, the spirit. They all mean almost the same thing, the psyche. They always consider everything personal. It's always a personal approach, a personal experience, a personal relationship. Personalan lagi ang norm. Because we are not the dominant race in the world, I guess. I mean, it's another discussion again for a university, but the Filipinos have had 300 or 400 years of struggle, of oppression, colonization. Perhaps our history, education, and culture nurtured that in us, but dumb or smart, rich or poor, our great equalizer is how a person loves. The heart, the Filipino heart. There's no denying that. Whenever we export all our products, our soaps are exported to places like Africa, Nigeria, Kazakhstan, and translated into some kind of Russian language. But they always say one thing, we like it, we can show it, because the great equalizer is the Filipino heart, and it shows the product. So yung mga napaparoon natin soap or sound, you know, soap sa TV, and you find, for me, yung sentimental, modeling. Hey, actually, even the Eastern Europeans love it. Kasi, even if you don't understand each other's language, or culture, or location, or religion, the heart is the great equalizer. So if you have an app or whatever that wants to transcend the boundary of time and space, use the heart. Anyway, continue. The human heart is not so easy to map. So let's go one by one, as fast as I can, on what Maro has missed out and what you can hopefully not miss out on. Let's try to work in exploring the human heart. Siyempre, hindi mo pwedeng love a God, dapat percent, o hindi lang yan. Sabi mo mga scientist, ang mga yun, chemical attraction. So hindi pa pwedeng first impression. What is your first impression? Tumari, hindi kayo gumawa ng website or app or program. What is your first impression upon seeing it? Tumari, let's say it's a website and you're seeing the first page. Are you... Siyempre, appearance counts. Tingnan niyo muna how it looks. Is it cool? Sexy? I hope. Simple but interesting? Exciting? Parang tao rin, di ba? Or ang first impression, intimidating, not complicated? Tao man o app, what's the term? Kung hindi... cool, sexy, simple, but interesting, and sana exciting. But it's not me, it's you, the personal user. I meant the audience. Hindi, no, it's not you, it's me, mag-inistritan. Pero for now, gamitin muna natin, it's not me, it's you. The potential user is the first person you should check out. And to me, having experience a few developmental journeys with our team and other teams, and other scriptwriters, other storytellers. This is really the hardest, most difficult, the most easily fooled thing to undertake, knowing your potential user. In fact, let's start with who are they? Sino ang karelasyon mo? Sino ang future karelasyon mo? User lang ba? So ako nga na
pag-user na ako, awkward ako kasi user experience. Sa love story, sabihin niya magkagamit. User ka na! Inamit ko lang ako. Sa kalye, drug addict yan, user. So, okay lang. Gamitin niyo salitang user, but sino future ka relasyon mo? Market lang ba ang tingin mo sa kanila? Audience lang ba? Follower lang ba sa Twitter? At least sana friend, kaibigan, pero kaibigan lang pala. Wala pa, friend though. But see, that's why you would know that the networks use kapamilya, kapuso, kapatid, kabarkada for 2023 because they try to impose, they try to engender, to brainwash a relationship, a mode of relationship that cannot be described by saying you're a user. Kasi when you say you're a kapamilya, nandun lahat ang qualities na kapamilya. Pagtatanggol mo, tutulong mo mag-aral, pagtatrabaho mo. So you immediately hijack the heart of the viewer to say, ay, kapamilya ako. I don't mean hijack in a bad sense, of course, but to jumpstart that kind of link, saving kapuso, saving kapatid. May kaubusan ng linya, naging kapatid na lang ang TVG. Ang kapatid mo na, pwede mo namang kalimutan. See, what you can do is your user or ka-relasyon, a ka-tropa, ka-jami, ka-chismisan, a fellow bargain, a suki like OLX, a fellow bargain hunter, Amazon, a lover, I hope a lover. So, what is the relationship you wish to make with the person you wish to target in across the room in the park? Sinong lalapitan mo ng pick-up line? What kind of person is that? And therefore, paano mo siya tatratuin at anong relasyon? So know your target, but again, it's a bad word for us. It's not a target. It's a future relationship. We hope, we try to personalize it all the time. Tao kasi yan. Sure, the usual demos work, but go beyond. And explain Edmund to kanina, we'd like to think of our characters in the movies as laging a point in time and space. Kung ito ang time, x-axis, L, y-axis is space, lagi nasa point in time and space. All of us, even your app, is a point in time and space. You have to know and accept the fact that you're in the Philippines and you're so-and-so years old and that you belong to this town, you're not in the south, you're probably in Caloocan, wherever, whatever, social, economic, and so, because that's the way you express yourself in whatever you do. Language may be a determinant of space. What language we use? English, British language, formal, Taglish, colloquial, hello, pare, quirky, irreverent. How far do you want to take the language into whom you want to talk to? When you go to a party and meet the person and the person speaks in English, at least you want to speak in English, or you need the person and pakamabusan ka. Or you're in a party and the girl talks Jologs and I don't know, or Bading talk, oh, Sika, Mario, you probably will try to adapt at least, or leave. But get to know who you're talking to. Economic class is a form of space. What insights can you offer to these people at their level, not at your level? Edwin talks about this a lot too, about making the person, reaching out to the person in language he understands. Time not only refers to the reaction time you upload videos or the reaction time, the speed of your website or your uploading, downloading, but also to the perspective of the people you are about to reach out to. What are their moral judgments, opinions, advice, interests, attitude, what sort of generation they belong to, and again, language. This is the hardest part, quite honestly, to pato. Because if you do not know who you're talking to, half of the battle is lost. In ABS-CBN, and I'm speaking something confidentially, I hope I don't give too much, we actually divide people to achievers, adventurers, romantics, and other classifications. I'm going to speak very generally. Because that's the way they find meaning in whatever they do. An achiever, you would want to create a website that makes the person sort of accomplish something or level up. But for an adventurer, you want an exploration, a journey. For a romantic or a connector, you want meeting up things, talking to other people things, chatting things. So, I don't have the technical terms for that, but you see, iba ang slant, even if it's the same service, depending on the kind of person you're talking to. And a lot of the apps and a lot of the sites that we sometimes encounter seems to express more of the person making it rather than of the person they're talking to. Doon lang kami medyo nagkakaroon ng misgiving. And I know you know that when you see an app that's so unmalleable or can't quite understand it, like the signboard in EDSA, that's when you see that the person is too full of himself rather than open to you. And that's when you leave the person in a party. That's when you, ay, tukha muna ako ng beer then. So, yun ang mayayari sa akin. Lonely. Imagine how the future karelasyon or future lover will experience your app. What kind of experience do you provide? Don't ever assume. Huwag assume na ilaba ka sa sanctuary. Maraming nasisirang relasyon sa taken for granted. Is the person individualistic, solo, and he does it, or is it social? He checks on whatever you're doing as a group. Is he purposive? Sigurado na siya sa kanyang hahanapin? Like in a classified ads, a Craigslist? Or is he exploring, she exploring, checking things out, trying to enjoy the digital space you give him or her? What is his or her emotional state? Lonely, looking for love, eager for knowledge, eager for thrill and excitement, eager for stimulation. Oh, it's stimulation, so it depends on what you do. So, what is the emotional state of the user, of the future lover? What will make them fall in love with you? What will make them say, stay with you throughout a longer time, para merong longer session minutes, whatever you intend to do? So, when we did this, we had an experience, just a little anecdote. When we were looking at Netflix, iFlix, and Blink, we said we have to do something like that because we're doing movies and they're all using our products. We export to iFlix and Netflix, iFlix mainly, and iTunes, but 5-year-old movies, so we don't want our newer movies to come out. But, okay, so they're there, so what do we do? Netflix is giving it for free with $9 a month in the second month. iFlix is giving it for 29 pesos in a month. So what do we do? So we had a lot of iterations on whatever platform, movie, rental platform to do, and we haven't launched this on confidential again, but I'd just like to say a little thing that made the breakthrough. So, tingin kami ng tingin, bakit ganun? Okay, so here's NARC, who has done, gone to Netflix? Wala. What an incredible situation. Yes, what did you watch? Aling doon?
For example, in 12 months.
Ah, talaga? Ano itin dyan? Gumiba pa ko after episode 2. Anyway, so nakapila silang ganun. So you get to watch it. But we can't fight the battle with Netflix, iFlix, and Blink. Ipipila lang namin ang movies namin. I mean, 12 Monkeys compared to, Forevermore. Baka naman manalo Forevermore. Pero House of Cards, Forevermore, baka manalo ng Forevermore. So we don't win the battle that way. And people might not get to us. But what will we do for a movie streaming rental service that might possibly stand the chance in making a dent against the foreign rental services? So we figured out, ano ba ang ginagawa ng Filipino? We watch the movies, of course. Oh, you watch movies in your ads or TV set. But the lower bracket Filipinos, the CBE, what do they do? Where do they go? So we find out that the Filipinos watch movies as a social event. It's either your family or your friends with you or your tita or your lola. And it's normally a communal event where you discuss. And the experience of the Filipinos happen way before the screening begins. It happens upon the first chismis that John Lloyd and Jenny will do a movie. So they talk about it in the jeep, or they talk about it in the text, or they talk about it on Facebook, and it goes on until the movie is shown. So sabi namin, when it comes to experience pala, we should not have assumed that the Netflix style of simple click and rent and stream and watch will play for the Filipinos. The experience of the Filipino movie-going public is that movie begins upon the first chismis that the movie is about to happen, all the way down until the third week when they're still discussing what's the best scene that the person cried to. So the experience of the American is this, the experience of the Filipinos is this. And the American experience is individual, click and play and watch. The Philippine experience is collective. So we adjusted our website, our streaming service accordingly. It's about to launch in a few months, but at least hindi pa mapakita bawal din. So at least don't ever assume that the experience will be the same. And that's just a movie rental. When you know your future karelasyon, comprehensively, only then can you do the approach. Siyempre, pa-impress ka muna. Normally, good impressions happen when the potential date, the one you see across the room, is at least easy, hindi man easy like an easy girl or something. Easy to figure out, medyo pagtingin mo na, intindihan mo, ah, she's perky. Ah, she's kind of elegant. Ah, he's a jock. Okay, so I talk basketball to him. Parang ganun. But if a person is too complicated, too alien, we get intimidated a bit, I guess, or try to at least circle the person, try to figure the person out. Ginagawa niyo ba yun? Or Tinder na lang? O dire-direcho na lang sa gypsy, kuha na lang ba sa Kami kasi, isip-ipot na lang kami. Anyway, baka naman ano, no? Baka naman I'm on the wrong generation. Sige, kuha na lang ba? Anyway, so I guess I could share something that Disney executive shared with me. I don't know if it's confidential, but anyway, shop talking between conferences. They try to simplify their products, mainly their main characters, mainly the princesses or the heroes, into at least two adjectives and one noun. And we may subconsciously do it, but we don't know it, but we sort of look at the person and say, ah, ito adjective niya, one adjective niya, one, isa ganito. Three adjectives baka hindi na. Too complicated na sa akin. Check it out when you think tonight if you do that way. Or maybe you don't do it at all, but in your head it is. But say, so let's see. So joy is a happy, nurturing emotion. Everything else in that movie, if you see inside out, is a corollary to those two adjectives and to that classification. She's an emotion. So anything that she did, if she's heroic, her heroism is based on a nurturing adjective. Whatever else did she do? It's all based on just two adjectives, the two most comprehensive and compassing adjectives that they can think of. At least it's a clear classification. Ariel is a curious and romantic mermaid. Everything else that she did, all the sacrifices for love that she did, is based on two adjectives. Elsa is a responsible, loving ice queen. At least may contrast, right? She's responsible and loving, but she's an ice queen. So. Carl is an adventurous and cantankerous widower. Nandun na lahat. Everything that you do, he did in the entire movie is based on those two. So, sometimes, whatever online creations you do, they're like characters too. They will develop the love story. And their users are like a relasyon. And to me, you might want to use as an exercise two adjectives. Can you describe whatever you do in two adjectives? The character, whatever creation you do in two adjectives. If it's a solution that's B2B, maybe not, maybe this is not the thing, but a campaign, an app, a design, practically anything, a layout, tingnan nyo, pag lumagpas ng two adjectives, it's complicated already. Let's try Amazon. I'll just try, maybe I'm wrong. To us, Amazon is a one-stop practical suki. It's your suki, everything's there, may value, may flash sale, one-stop lang, not to lack that you need. Nothing, it's not an elite, it's not a glamorous, it's not a first to own kind of place. It's just practical for Americans. It's a suki. They always go to Amazon and one stop for anything of your basic needs, from toilet paper to jeans. How about Apple? Ange and I used to have lots of debates on maybe we should imitate the Apple design years ago. That's sleek and ano, puti, and then just little products. Kaya lang sabi ko, Ange, hindi kasi tayo ganun kasi Apple is a sleek sci-fi geek temple. It is we see it as a temple in the sense that the products are like little gods in little cubicles in the altar. And it's a sci-fi geek thing. If you don't know what it does and it doesn't explain too well, then you're out. And you're not with us. We're way up there and catch up or you're not with us. Apple users they consider themselves a bit apart. And it's sleek. It's not overpopulated, it's not crowded. Parabang, it's like a spiritual experience. Ah, ito na. The bagong model ng iPad Pro. Nakaganon lang siya na, parang, or iPhone 6. Hindi na pwede. No, nothing else exists. no zombies or anything. You want to learn more, you click. I don't have to explain it to you on the first page. So stars in my baduoy, sorry guys. Only home. Aki assistant niya nanginagay of all things. Hindi man lang OTJ or award winning. Anyway, oh my God. 3 a.m. ko na nakita rin social. But you see, it doesn't have to be the tip of the rocket that NASA will launch tomorrow. It's a filial testing time. And very critical that we say that it's a time because we have families, we have geeks, we have adventurers, we have men, we have women, we have Jacob, everybody, but they're all at least fan personality when they enter. Tested because they may be happy, they may be sad, but they're tested. Ito ba maging tested, maski malungkot ka. And filial because it's family-oriented, or at least bangkadang pang-pamilya. And it supplies the personality well enough, we benefit from it, it serves the purpose of our karelasyon. Some online creations may even forego too many words. Sometimes, nowadays, first impression is tied to the overall environment kasi syempre kanta sa ating mga graphics. Minsan, it's where the first date happens. Maybe the place is a character but also a universe that you enter to, nagiging immersive na. In movies, we call it minsan-san or milieu. You begin to fall in love with the person along with the place that you get yourself into. I saw the early ones to a certain point. Medyo immersive yung kandang website. Ano sila, parang platform sila, parang YouTube. Pero may iba silang goal na inahabol. Mas urban, mas elite, mas yung dati ng Tumblr crowd. Mas bata ng Tumblr crowd, mas you're in when you're with us. Inahabol nila sa Europe. But anyway, mas immersive, so you don't really show too much. So you exploit and enter the world. You try to imitate that. We're hoping to more or less give the same experience. If you notice kanina, it's fiesta, fiesta, di ba, Tommy, gano'n, gano'n. Star cinema. This is still star cinema, but we're tackling now. Can we start from the start? This hasn't been shown anywhere else yet, so pinag-usapan ko lang yung takita. So yan po nang organize ng IA ninyo. Ano yung good trusted, Angela? So hindi na rin kami masyadong mga graphic-graphics, pinapakita na lang namin ganun. And so the person, I hope, gets immersed a little more than to read through. Continues, kasi it will ask you what you want. Mali yung Galaxy Gear, di ba? Sakit ni Samsung. Tapos pag ganyan Daniel Padilla ka, kasi Daniel Padilla ka medyo, ano naman siya? Which means... So, automatic, gano'n. So, naka-CMS, naka-content management na lahat sa bawat circle. Why am I showing this? Not that it's the best graphics. It's probably one of the most advanced that we're proud of to say. But because, as you can see kanina sa Fiesta ng Star Cinema website, this website is for mainly for B2B within the business. So the sleepness and the sophistication can probably be born by foreign suppliers looking at us, by Americans, by advertising agencies who want our songs. So ibang purpose, ibang goal, ibang karelasyon na gustong makuha, ibang entire design, ibang milieu, ibang misansan, iba ang overall wraparound. I hope that's what I'm getting through. After you magpa-impress at nagka-interest sa inyo, you get to know each other. Normally, people like to befriend others with common wavelengths, common interests, common tastes, common language. It's important that you focus on a single core beloved, like, for example, family, and saka ng friends, saka ng community, or focus on male adventurers, saka ng iba, saka ng bigger market. Kasi at least, may one-on-one feeling that you're focused on a certain single personality. Then you broaden outwards. When you explore each other, is the experience interesting as you enter, let's say, the website? Are you engaging at every turn? Or is the date too coy, masyadong hinahanap ko pa kung information sa kanya. Or sa day 2 po siya, nagbebenta ka agad sa'yo, nagpaparegister ka agad, merchant page ka agad. I don't know. But when you do it, just consider that. Maybe you can call it gamification of registration, but we call it courtship, we call it baiting in, making the person love us step by step, bit by bit. To do that, kahit walang commitment, don't assume, kahit walang commitment, don't assume na mahal ka niya. What can make them explore you further? What experience, content, prosperity, engagement? What will not intimidate them? Of course, not all users, commit on the first day. Keep them habituated, interested, engaged with stories. Whether the stories are complete or not, whether it's a revelation of an anecdote, but keep them interested in your stories. Users will not turn to lovers if you're a stranger or a one-trick pony or a one-story storyteller. Tell your story. I don't think we have time to explore it, but naganap lang ako ng pinakamabilis na nakita ko lang sa tabi ng Yahoo doon, na two shops that are common at typical of products. So these are both selling leather bags. Go to Kendall and Hyde, double L yan yata. Ayun, single L lang pala, Y. And see, para, they're telling you a story. The video is always a little parang filtered and sexy yung leather, and they tell you how they do it, where they source the leather, vegetable tanning, they explain to you the basis, the person who sold it is there. It tells a story. If you have time, please compare it to a Belgian site. Ruta Tase naman, 100 years of bad making. Quality for you. Parang pinagyabang niya yung kanyang pagka-Nazi. Yung isa naman, nasabi sa iyo, boy, vegetable tanning ito, walang danger, it's good to the touch. Compare nyo lang, makikita nyo ang difference when a person is telling a story, even if he's just selling bags, and a Belgian is saying, we have the best. Parang so. So, they makikita nyo. So, this is the only time I will mention information architecture because I don't know much about it. The information architecture of Kendall is much different from Luther Tassin, even if Luther Tassin is superior, in 100 years. Because Kendall chose to tell the story of how they do the bags, and Luther Tassin just puts it out there and expects you to be. The way the information is classified, introduced, curated, expressed in sexy pictures with leather, na well-lit, is sexy, beguiling, tactile, prudent, and very curated in its speed. Maybe, just maybe, the user will become a future lover and will go to bed with you. But I don't mean literally. Maybe he will purchase, she will purchase or generate content for you. He will spread the love, introduce you, spread you, repost you. At least register para may pan-database kayo or kumayag siya, i-flag niyo siya with your alerts. Of course, just because may love, hindi ibig sabihin wala nang kapatan. User pa nila. Kasi kung sa pag-ibig may kapatan. We love someone when that someone makes us feel good. You make your users feel good. We love someone if that someone mirrors our best interest. That's why you have to own in on a core audience or a core user and address that as if he's the single person in the world. Then it will broaden accordingly. Love someone who's in a deeper and deeper manner that someone allows us to peek into our soul. That's what I was saying in the back when the factory, they're telling us about who they are, what they do, how they sold it, and this is the picture, these are the jeans that they use, etc. We love someone if our contribution is valued, if you're personally responded to right away, if they answer right away your queries, whatever, or if you click into something that you want and they answer right away, or honestly say, oops, we haven't made that page yet, so sorry, go back to main page. At least honest. We love someone who will benefit from that someone. And yan, pumasok din ang consumer benefit. Of course, consumer benefit is critical and non-negotiable. But sana, alongside the love. So, natural din na lahat ng narinig niyo, logical design, ease of use, speed, cost, hopefully none, approximate level of commitment, naging gamify nyo rather than all or nothing, fulfillment of promise, and performance. If you promise a holiday in Boracay, don't give a stroll in Manila Bay. Don't overpromise and underdeliver. Pep just promises the local showbiz news from all networks. So from all networks, comprehensively, good or bad news, with strict and acceptable journalistic taste. But it's all out there, up front, the very first thing that you see. So that's why they're number one in the local gossip. But, that's right. But when you go to CNN.com, more reportage, less opinion, a balanced worldview storytelling, pero, kanina naman spelling. But they're politically correct. Ang opinion nila minimal, except under Cooper and Corina na nag-away. Generally, ano sila, parang halos plain vanilla nga reporting nila. Iba sa Fox, di ba? Who are Republicans, very clear personality nila. Very clear, kailang na-attack Midwestern American Bible Belt, predominantly white WASP, white Anglo-Saxon Protestant. Very clear. ang CNN, clear then where the generic worldview. Iba rin naman, ang New York Times. It's also a worldview, pero curated through the filters of an intelligent East Coast American with a New York state of mind, with a New York cultural barometer. They might report the same news, but based on the personality of the creator and based on the market that they address. So, Huffington Post, I'm sure mas alam nyo to, populist, rabble-rousing, maybe tabloidish na, pagdating sa SEO, talagang garapala, ano. At least, SEO sila labi. A bit female, so, hindi na naman yung ginaba, marami pa doon na mga mas sensitive. BuzzFeed, alam nyo naman, halos satire na. Halos poop na. May susunod pa, The Onion, Clickhole, mas satire pa, mas poop pa. So, madali lang kasi i-explain through news sites ang difference ng personality kasi makikita niyo yung slides on who they address. And Yahoo. Kaya nagkang dalugilug eh. Di mo alam kung sino kausap eh. Isa sa So finish, when the time comes, when the productive relationship between you and your beloved deepens, you can actually demand from your lover a few tests of love. User review, UGC, helping out like ways or advocacy, contributing information, fundraising, you have a bond. Nahihingan nyo na sila ng support. But that's only pag nagawa na ninyo, entire journey of love. There it is. Just a few tips before we wrap up. Don't forget si Paring Maslow, the biggest ano pa rin, when you go to BuzzFeed or what is that, pamamatay na tayo bukas, earthquake apocalypse. It's always survival, then security, and then love, and then bago mag-self-actualize. So baka nasa self-actualization kayo, survival ang pala gusto ng market. And don't forget the priority of man. Unahin ang self, then the second priority is family, lovers, friends, bago magpunta sa planet. Baka po environmental, and gusto naman niya mabasa is my mother is an ex whatever. Yung pala, scandal pala. So, to wrap up, your love affair with your user started the great first impression, engaging exploration, self-revelation in you as creator, allowing them also to self-reveal when they give themselves up to you, perpetual courtship, deepening, commitment, fulfillment of your promise, effort or sacrifice on the part of your user so that you could test whether they will stay with you, and then it becomes a bond. Not but a love story successful? Of course not. Meron hindi lahat ay happy ending, but I believe that without love, you don't stand a chance. That's it. Thank you.